because I see here are some questions, also some sayings by Shingyo. So Shingyo said related to Oya-sama. So Shingyo says, Oya-sama, mother, father, never rejects anybody. His embrace is forever. He will never let go, but lead you to the pure land. It is absolute acceptance of us as we are. We simply accept this light of Amida by opening our minds. And of course, we can and should turn to him for direction to the Dharma. So this comment of Shingyo is also addressed to you, Daigan, to your question, to your previous question.
Yes.
You have the words of Shingyo here in the chat. Okay. Thank you, Shingyo. And Shingyo also says here, so the best thing is to get rid of karma. Amida Buddha will cut off our karma. Yes. And now a question. Does each Buddha have his own pure land? For example, Shakyamuni Buddha's pure land is Mount Gridhrakuta. If I'm not mistaken, there is even a pure land of its own by one of the Buddhas who saves the Naraki beings. He wants to say Naraka beings, that means hell beings. The other Buddhas have their own pure land. Do the Buddhas of the pure land of Sukhabati have their pure lands? Well, that's a difficult question. I don't know. If you become a Buddha in the pure land, you can go everywhere and create as many pure lands as you want, if you want. But I think, for example, what I would like to do is not to create my own pure land, but to help all the beings go to the pure land. So I imagine myself as a future Buddha, bringing everybody to the pure land of Amida, who is already the best pure land ever. So according to the Jodo Shinshu teaching, yes, any Buddha can have his own pure land. He can manifest a special sphere of influence with certain characteristics and features. Padmasambhava also has his own pure land. I don't know about the pure land of Shakyamuni Buddha too much because I was not interested to learn. But you can read in various sutras. So I don't know what to say. But what I can say for sure, according to the teaching of our lineage masters, is that Amida's pure land is the best pure land among all the pure lands of various Buddhas. That is all I say. And especially, it is the best pure land because it is most easy to access. It is like a country who has absolutely no laws for the immigrants. And everybody can emigrate to the pure land. No visas, no requirements. Everybody can immigrate. So, only to say the name of Amida, to entrust to him and wish to go there. While in other pure lands, if you read the conditions for accessing the pure lands of other Buddhas, you will see there are many other conditions. And some of the conditions is to develop a special state of mind or a special quality. But in the pure land of Amida, you need no quality, no special thing. Only Nembutsu of faith. That's all. Namu Amida Butsu. And I can go there. It's so simple. I don't think other pure lands have these simple conditions. And this is the teaching of our lineage masters, that the pure land of Amida is the best. So we take this, we accept this. I see in the chat that you are okay with this, Shingyo. Namo Amida Butsu, Shingyo. Thank you for your comments and questions.